so excited. Well, I thought lingerie and charity, what better way to get people out to support a great cause? And, it's for empowering women, and it's providing a really great opportunity for women to support their families, to create their own businesses, to support themselves in any way that they need to do that they're not usually, the chances that they don't usually have. And so this microfinancing and investment empowers women to really make a difference in their own life and invest in themselves. Miami is the sexiest city in the States, I think. So it's a perfect match.
Was amazing, did I tell you? And those girls were so beautiful. And you gotta give it up for Eva Longoria. She's definitely one of the hottest chicks on TV. Now we take a quick commercial break, but when we come back, we're going back to last year's Super Bowl in Tampa, where I got one-on-one with female heartthrob Ray J and the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world, Floyd Mayweather. We'll be right back.
Coming up next, Keri Hilton, Will I Am, Ray J, and Floyd Mayweather. Plus, John Legend and the late, great Michael Jackson. We'll be right back.
Welcome back. Now, last year's Super Bowl, I had a chance to interview like everybody in sports, plus in music and in movies. But when I had a chance to go one-on-one with Ray J and Floyd Mayweather on the same interview, you know I had to go there. But before we check that out, we're going out to L.A. for a special event called How I Write the Song. And my co-host, Cameron Miller, sits down with the lead singer of Black Eyed Peas' Will.i.am and pop sensation, Keri Hilton. So, Cam, take it away.
We're right here with Miss Keri Hilton herself.
Miss Keri, baby.
What is an event, doing an event like this, How I Wrote That Song, you being a huge songwriter, singer, arranger, background, all of that. How does,
Well, you know what? It's important because songwriters usually don't get the attention that the producers and artists get. So anytime that I can be an inspiration for any songwriter coming up, I'm there.
Mike, I'm here with Will.i.am. He actually puts the black in the Black Eyed Peas. How's it going today, man?
What up, CBS Miami? Chilling.
Man, you've done everything in the business, pretty much, from being in the background, being on in front in the spotlight. What's your favorite part? What's the most gratifying to you? Creating the music, performing the music?
Traveling.
Traveling.
I really like touring.
Yeah.
Because touring, you get to perform, you get to write on the road. You're working in the hotel on songs, and then you go and you play in front of 40,000 people, 50,000 people, 100,000 people. In Brazil, we played in front of 1,500,000 people. You know they watching. You got them. You're inspiring. They're inspiring you. You're making beautiful music. You're making them dance. You're making them have a good time. That is real. That's my favorite part.
Hi, everybody. You watch On The Mic with yours truly, Mike Sherman, here in Tampa, Florida for the Super Bowl weekend with pound for pound the best fighter in the world, Floyd Mayweather, and one of the best R&B artists ever, Ray J. Gentlemen, thank you so much for coming on my show.
You know it's all love. Thanks for having me, baby. I'm here.
How did you get involved on the music side? You're sponsoring concerts now with Keisha Cole and T-Pain, and you're involved with Ray J. You used to have an artist, H. Flo, I had on the show a couple years ago. Talk about now your influence in today's music.
Well, I have nothing but love for music. You learn to absorb all that type of music, and you keep it in, and you look at different artists these days. You got Ray J, and the list goes on and on.
Now, Ray J, your last joint with Young Berg, Sexy Can I was all over the country. Ringtone just killed it. You're with Koch, independent side, which you make more money, you know, on the units now, you know, the big Sonys and the Warner Music Groups, you know, they monopolize a lot of the money when they go out there and push your stuff. How did that experience go, going with Koch and kind of being in control of your own destiny, work with Mayweather Music moving forward?
Well, you know, it's like Floyd. Floyd is self-made, you know what I'm saying? Like, he takes it from the ground and takes it all the way to the top. And that's what I like to do with my music. Like, I'm independent ever since One Wish. When One Wish went a million, and then I came back with Sexy Can I, and we went triple platinum with the singles. But all of that's independent. And I feel like if I had a right machine and somebody that has the same vision like me, like Floyd, then I feel like we can be at the top of our game as well. And so, you know, we've been hanging out since I was little, man, and I've always looked up to Floyd, so it's about that time, you know, it's well overdue.
That was a great piece to go one-on-one with Keri Hilson and will.i.am, two of my favorites. Good job. And for me to sit down with Ray J and Floyd Mayweather, that was quite an experience. And Floyd Mayweather is never lost for words. By the way, he's fighting Manny Pacquiao for the fight of the century in March for the best fighter, pound for pound, in the world. You guys definitely don't want to miss that. Now, our next guest is one of the biggest pop stars in the world. In fact, he's so big, he sells out in concerts all over the world. United Kingdom, Israel, Amsterdam, plus all over the U.S. John Legend, we're now going to see him perform. We're also going to say goodbye to another legend, the late, great Michael Jackson. I was fortunate enough to film him last year at Christian Audigier's 50th birthday party. So let's take a look.
Maybe it's me, maybe I bore you. No, no, it's my fault, 'cause I can't afford you. Maybe, baby, Puffy, Jay-Z would all be better for you. All I could do was love you.
Michael Jackson piece like yesterday. It was unbelievable. And when I met Mike for the first time, I mean, he gave me goosebumps. Rest in peace, Mike. Now we take a quick commercial break, but when we come back, the show is just getting started. We've got interviews from Flo Rida, Pamela Anderson, Carmen Electra, and Vin Diesel. We'll be right back.
Coming up next, Flo Rida, Pamela Anderson, Carmen Electra, Vin Diesel, Fergie, and some hot swimsuit fashion shows. Trust me, you don't want to miss this.